Hello, this is Patricia with the Crazy Cat Lady Crochet and Crafts channel. I hope you are doing well today. In this video, I'd like to show you how I crocheted this. I called it the heavy duty the dish rag. You certainly don't want to use this on your body. It's made with Hobby Ribbon. I'm not affiliated with them. This is 100% cotton. And for this project, I use a size 6 hook, and we will need some scissors. These dishcloths they're soft, but they're very durable. I've been using one, not this one in particular, I've been using one for probably about over a month now, and it is still retaining its shape very well. And the great thing about them is they don't smell. Usually a dish rag, after you use it for a little bit, will get that soured smell. They don't do that. So let's get started. I'm going to take the label off because I like pulling from the outside. And this color of Hobby Ribbon is, well, they call it color 18. I call it dark red. I don't see any other indication on here of a color. So, dark red it is. Just get your ribbon, and we'll pull a bunch of it off because this is going to use a lot of ribbon. Let's see where that gets us to. And so, first thing that we're going to need to do is make a slip knot. And then chain 19. I think I'd like it longer than that. Let's go for 20, 21, 22. Looks good. And then the second chain from the hook, go ahead and single crochet all the way back to the beginning. you do want to leave your stitches kind of snug, because when this gets wet, it's going to expand, and over time, it may stretch. So I myself leave the stitches a little bit snug. I'm going to pause the video, and when you get done crocheting all the way to the end, press play, and I'll be here to tell you what to do for the next step. Hi. Now that I have crocheted all the way to the end of the chain, I'm going to chain one, turn my work, and then single crochet all the way across. And that's really all you do for this dishcloth is single crochet each row until the dishcloth is square, or until it is your desired size. So at this time I'm going to pause the video. And when I get the dishcloth to the desired size, I'll come back on and tell you what the next step is. Just keep single crocheting, and at the end of each row, chain one and turn, and crochet down the row. It's quite simple. I'll meet you back here when I'm done crocheting all the rows. Okay, here we are at my desired size of the dishcloth. It is 8 inches wide and 7 inches long. You could most certainly weave this end in, tie this off, and leave the dishcloths like this. Or you could do what I'm going to do. I'm going to go around the edges with a single crochet and give it a more finished look. And to do that, I'm just gonna, after the last stitch, my dishcloth ended up being 22 rows. So I'm going to chain one, and then every row I'm just gonna do a single crochet. This will make it look a little bit more, give it a more finished look, and help it retain its shape. I need to pull some more out. Just every row where you see that gap, just insert your hook there. and do a single crochet. When you get to the corner, go ahead and do two single crochets in your corner. Got a little hit of myself there. I was thinking about the tail on the corner. The tail on the corner, I'm going to lean in toward where I'm working. And that way I'll catch it when I'm crocheting down the row. I just want to say while we're doing this, if you like this video, be sure to give me a thumbs up. And if you'd like to continue getting videos from me, go ahead and subscribe. And if you'd like to be notified of when I'm uploading videos, go ahead and click the notification bell. If today is your first day watching one of my videos, thank you for stopping by and watching it. And if you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for subscribing to my channel and coming back and watching this video. I am on Instagram as Crazy Cat Lady Crocheting Crafts, and if you make this heavy duty dishcloth, be sure and tag me in it. I'd love to see how yours turned out. So, right here you see how I'm catching the tail as I'm crocheting over. And that's just one less thing that I have to weave in later on. Here we're coming up to the corner, so be sure and do two single crochets in the corner. That makes it turn nice. Going down the side, just hit each row. It'll probably be, there's a row, and there's a gap. So do one there. On this piece, it's pretty obvious where the rows are. I And with this dishcloth, you can do more than just wash dishes with it. It's a make a good cleaning cloth too, because it is sturdy, it is thick, and the texture of the stitches gives it a nice scrubbing texture. You don't have to be gentle with it. The ribbon makes it very sturdy. And when it comes time to wash it, I just throw mine in the wash machine. And when it's done washing, I do not put it in the dryer. I just put it back out on the sink and for continued use, or if you have more than one and you're rotating them, just take it out when you take it out of the wash machine. I recommend laying it flat. You don't want to use fabric softener on these, because fabric softener will reduce the amount of absorbency. So we want our dishcloth to have absorbency, so limit how much fabric softener you expose it to. This is the last side. Pulling some ribbon out. There we go. Tighten up this stitch a little bit right here. There we go. And as you're doing this, of course, you want to keep your stitches a little bit snug because this is what's going to help the dishcloth hold its shape. This is a quick and easy project. You make several of these in different color ribbons, and they make good birthday gifts, Mother's Day gifts, Christmas stocking stuffer gifts. And they're fairly quick to crochet while you're watching TV. You really don't have to pay that much attention to what you're doing. Here we are at the last stitch. We only did one stitch in that corner, so I'm going to put another one in there if it'll let me. It's being pretty stubborn. There we go. Once you get your stitch made, go ahead and do a single crochet and tie off. Cut a long tail. Pull it through. And once you weave it in, which I'll do in after a little bit, this will be your finished discard. Well, I've enjoyed this time with you. I hope you enjoy your dishcloth. It is a very sturdy dishcloth. And join me for my next video where we'll make something similar, only it's going to be the super scrubber dishcloth that's got these little scrubby nubbies. So be sure to join me for that video. And as always, thank you for clicking on this video and have a nice rest of the day.